Peter Youngren's and World Impact Ministry's first foray into Ethiopia in 2001 became a historical breakthrough for the gospel. Pastors across the country are still talking about the impact from the campaign in the Hosanna region. Many call it the largest ever gathering for the gospel in the country of Ethiopia. There was a sea of people responding with great joy. One of the notable events was the salvation of the Orthodox high priest, who had done everything in his power to stop the campaign, even printing handbills with a photo of Peter Youngren with the number 666 imprinted into his forehead. The high priest, Abba Haile Gabriel, later testified of how Jesus spoke to him in a supernatural way and told him that Peter Youngren would be able to help him to discover who Jesus really is. This led to the high priest attending the opening night and watching how Jesus showed himself alive by healing people. But the next night, the high priest came to the platform to give his testimony. The effects were powerful as the entire region turned out for the gospel campaign, almost completely emptying surrounding towns and villages of people. This initial breakthrough for the gospel led to many other campaigns in cities like Awasa, Kibre Magiste, Nazareth, and Addis Ababa. Another historical campaign was held in Islam's fourth holiest city, Harar, located on the border to Somalia. Even here, thousands of Muslim friends came to the stadium to hear the news of Jesus Christ. Parallel with these gospel campaigns, there have been pastor seminars, each 3 days in length, where more than 27,000 pastors and leaders from across Ethiopia have received training. Peter Youngren became quickly aware that many areas of Ethiopia are untouched by the gospel, in particular those areas where Islam has dominated for many centuries. This led to a renewed interest to breakthrough for the gospel in those very areas that evangelical ministries seem to avoid. As in all countries, Peter Youngren works in an approach of friendship and respect towards people of all religions, meeting with the various religious leaders, seeking friendship and common understanding, all in an effort to open the door so that the gospel can be clearly presented. The campaign in Dire Dawah, where 95% of the population claim adherence to Islam, was historical. There were many notable miracles and even great reception from the Muslim mayor of this large city. With the motto that hearing the gospel is a basic human right, World Impact Ministries is continuing to hold campaigns, most recently in Islamic areas of Ziwai and Jimma.